engineers to use not sponges but small electrodes, many of them. And by guiding them, you have different amounts of currents to each electrode, achieve perhaps more focal stimulation. If you're an EEG person, nobody sane in your mind would do EEG with two big sponges. That makes no sense at all. Use small electrodes in EEG so that you get some sort of spatial focality. Identical stimulation with electric stimulation. Nobody's sane in their mind that would like to do focal stimulation with electric stimulation should use sponges. Instead, you use a collection of small electrodes. Makes perfect sense. The question, however, is, well, how are we supposed to split up these currents to go through these small electrodes? And so there's analytical solutions to this problem. It's really an optimization problem. And we published on that. The most recent work we've done on this is to use EEG recorders to do so. So the notion here is, imagine you have a neural activity that's fairly focal, say that was the case, and you look at how that looks on the surface of this, the skull. It's kind of a blurry thing for the very nature that the skull and CSF bear the signal a lot. So the question is, if this is what I measure with EEG, this could be an evoked response, this is, could be an SSVP, whatever your favorite EEG signal is, invariably it will be distributed. The question is, how should I, can I use this activity as I observe it on the surface to guide my choice of electrode placement and currents that go through each of these small high definition electrodes so that I achieve a stimulation of that very same thing? Well, the naive approach is to would be to say, well, these are the voltage distribution I measure. I'm going to apply little currents to electrodes placed like so, more or less the way I observe the voltage. I would call that naive reciprocity, which is sort of naively trying to inject the current back in proportionally to the voltage. If you do a little math, it turns out that the right thing to do is to take those voltage measurements and pre-multiply with this expression here, which is essentially an inverse of the lead field. Lead field is what source modelers use to try to understand how this current from the brain flow onto the surface of the skull. You take that, essentially you inverse it, multiply with the measured voltages, and it gives you the ideal current distribution that will achieve stimulation that's as close as possible to the original current source distribution. So this is what we also just published. Please come talk to Jacek on Monday about this in his book.